Hello and welcome to the FRITZ 16 video tutorials. In this little series of videos, I'd like to show you some of the new features of FRITZ 16. My name is Matthias and I'm one of the developers of the FRITZ user interface. Let's have a look at the new entry screen for FRITZ. We tried to make important functions, things you use often, right here available in this first window so that you can reach them by one button click. These functions, these buttons, are grouped into three columns. On the left you'd find the chess program FRITZ to play and analyze. The middle group of buttons accesses the chess server, play chess, where you can watch grandmaster games or play yourself. And on the right, this column leads to our web applications, the web apps, and because FRITZ 16 contains a membership with a chess-based account, a premium membership, this will offer you additional functionality with interesting training and chess functions. Okay, let's try to log in with our chess-based account by clicking on log in on the top here, and once you are logged in, the program knows this, and your login will be valid wherever you need it, whether you log in for Play Chess or use the Engine Cloud or work with Let's Check. It's just one login at the start, and that's much more smooth than in the earlier FRITZ versions. Clicking on login, I need to enter my password. All right, so you can see my picture here, so this has worked. If I click on my account name, this will lead me to a web page where I can edit and manage anything which has to do with my ChessBase account. All right, back to the entry screen. Just one final remark about the way we structured the program now. You see, the FRITZ is a program which is in the market for many years, and typically such programs tends to get crowded menus because every update adds new functions, and sometimes developers are scared to cut away older functions because the usage statistics show that many people still use older functionality quite happy, and so the program grows, the menus get more crowded. And at some stage, you need to restructure things to keep it handy and easily understandable. And we decided to split the way you use the program into two main use cases. One is playing against the program. This is what we call easy game, because this is also interesting and new here. And the other is entering and analyzing, storing, replaying, commenting games. And this leads, separating these two use cases leads to much simpler menus. And so FRITZ 16, I think we can say that this is much easier to use in many aspects. Thank you very much.